Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host, Deepa Soman, and these are the major news stories of Sunday, May 12th, 2024. Aam Aadmi Party Chief Arvind Kejriwal has announced Kejriwal Ki Guarantee, listing 10 works, including the freedom of Indian land from Chinese occupation. A fourth Indian has been arrested in Canada for his suspected role in the killing of Khalistan separatist Hardeep Singh Nijjar. Despite the international outcry against the revival of military attacks, Israel pushed back into northern Gaza and has upped the military pressure on Rafah. Flash floods caused by heavy rains have devastated villages in northern Afghanistan that left 315 people dead and more than 1,600 injured. With the summer rain spreading to more areas in Kerala, IMD sounded a yellow alert in 5 districts on Sunday. Let's get into the details. Delhi Chief Minister and Aam Aadmi Party National Convener Arvind Kejriwal on Sunday announced Kejriwal Ki Guarantee. He listed 10 works that will be done on war footing, including to free Indian land from Chinese occupation if the India bloc forms government at the centre. The opposition bloc, which has parties such as Aam Aadmi Party, Congress, Trinamool Congress, Dravida Munnetra Kazhagam, among others as its members, was formed to take on the BJP-led National Democratic Alliance in the Lok Sabha polls. A day after his release from jail on interim bail, Kejriwal on Saturday said the India bloc will form the next government and his AAP will be part of it. Addressing a press conference on Sunday, the AAP leader said people will have to choose between Modi Ki Guarantee and Kejriwal Ki Guarantee. The latter is a brand, Kejriwal said. On the announcement of his guarantees, Kejriwal said, "I have not discussed with my India bloc partners about this. I will press upon my India bloc partners to fulfill their guarantees." A fourth Indian national has been arrested by Canadian authorities in connection with the killing of Khalistan separatist Hardeep Singh Nijjar. This is a week after police arrested 3 Indians linked with high-profile case that has severely strained India's relations with Canada. 22-year-old Amandeep Singh, a resident of Brampton, Surrey and Abbotsford areas of Canada, has been charged with first-degree murder and conspiracy to commit murder. 45-year-old Nijjar was killed outside Guru Nanak Singh Gurudwara in Surrey, British Columbia on June 18, 2023. The Integrated Homicide Investigation Team of the Royal Canadian Mounted Police said that Singh was arrested on May 11th for his role in the killing of Nijjar. He was already in the custody of the Peel Regional Police for unrelated firearms charges, the release said. Israel sent tanks into eastern Jabalia in the northern Gaza Strip early on Sunday. This is after a night of heavy aerial and ground bombardments, killing 19 people and wounding dozens of others, health officials said. Jabalia is the biggest of Gaza's 8 historic refugee camps and is home to more than 100,000 people. Most of them were descendants of Palestinians who were driven from towns and villages. Late on Saturday, the Israeli military said forces operating in Jabalia are preventing Hamas, which controls Gaza, from re-establishing its military capabilities there. "We identified in the past weeks attempts by Hamas to rehabilitate its military capabilities in Jabalia. We are operating there to eliminate those attempts," said Rear Admiral Daniel Hagari, Israel's military spokesperson, during a briefing to reporters. Hagari also said that Israeli forces operating in Gaza City's Seiton district killed about 30 Palestinian militants. Flash floods caused by heavy rains have devastated villages in northern Afghanistan. 315 people were killed and more than 1,600 were injured, authorities said on Sunday. Thousands of homes were damaged and livestock wiped out, while aid groups warned of damage to healthcare facilities and vital infrastructure such as water supply, with streets left coated in mud. In a statement, the Taliban's economy minister, Din Muhammad Hanif, urged the United Nations, humanitarian agencies and private business to provide support for those hit by the floods. More Kerala districts are expected to receive the summer rain that has brought a big relief from the sweltering heat. A yellow alert has been issued in Pathanamthitta district till May 16, Thursday. Yellow alerts are also in place for Thiruvananthapuram on May 14th, Thiruvananthapuram and Kollam on May 15th, and Thiruvananthapuram, Kollam and Pathanamthitta on May 16th. A yellow alert indicates rainfall ranging from 64.5 mm to 115.5 mm in 24 hours. There is no warning for fishermen so far. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Deepa Soman, and produced by Vishnu Muralidharan, with technical support from Idea Brew Studios. Follow on manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news, and be sure to come back tomorrow.